Okay, good afternoon, everybody. Girls and guys. So, we start today's class. There's no Taiwanese student? Any Taiwanese student? No? Okay, so all you are international student. So, anyone come from United States? Okay, United States. Canada. Two from Canada. From Europe. Okay. Six or seven. Which country you come from?
Germany.
Okay. Yeah, I met a German scholar yesterday. They visit my center, MIPS Research Center. Any other from Germany? One, two, three, oh. So we have four from Germany. Okay, anyone from France? Oh, wait. From Paris? Oh, okay. Very good. Very beautiful city. Okay, so we start today's class. The course name for this the name for this course, Scientific Taiwan. My name is Xun, Hong Jin Xun. I'm professor in this Institute of Applied Mechanics. I'm also a director of NEMS Research Center. We have one clean room in this building. Maybe you can see, if we have time, we can visit my center or clean room now. Maybe sometime this semester. And there is another professor, Professor Lai, Lai Yixiong in Chinese, Robert Yixiong Lai. He is not available today. Will be available sometime later, later this year. Now he is in United States. He is a former chief professor of Datong University. General Education Center, Tongsi Zhongxin, in Chinese, and also a former chairman of the board, National Applied and Research Lab. He just retired from Datong University. And one more thing for this course, we are going to take a video every class. So just ignore. So just I'm going to explain the course and watch the video and maybe ask you some question, and you may ask a question or answer the question. So just ignore the video, video camera, okay? And please write down your name and your ID number and your email and maybe some other information, like a phone number. There are some table. Please write down some information, personal data. Okay, so let me have more information concerning myself. My name, last name, Xun, first name, Hong Jun. In Chinese, Shen Hongjun. Anybody know Mandarin? Two? Only two? Three? Okay. Yeah, how many people in the world use Mandarin? How many people? How many people in the world?
1.4 billion.
1.4 billion. 1.4 billion, yeah. Yeah, how many percentage? Concerning in the world, for the population of in the world.
15%.
15%?
Yeah.
15 or 20? Between 15 to 20% of the people in the world use Mandarin. So if possible, try learn something. Maybe later you are going to do some business. with in Taiwan or in mainland China, and you need to speak Mandarin. Okay, so I got my PhD degree long time ago, 1987, in United States, Stony Brook, in New York City, New York State. And after that, right now I'm professor in this this institute. And I'm also the director of NEMS Research Center. NEMS stands for Nano Electromechanical System. As I say, in my center we have a lot of very expensive equipment, more than like $10 million US dollars, much more than $10 million US dollars. Okay, and I was also a North Regional Center for Nanotech Higher Education and K-12 education. What's K-12? Anybody know? K-12 education.
Kindergarten
to 12th grade. Yeah, very good. Yeah. Yeah, for very small kids. Yeah, kindergarten, maybe a primary school, junior high school, senior high school. And higher education stands for college. University student or graduate student. Okay, next. Professor Rob Lai, his name in Chinese, Lai Yixiong in Chinese. English name Rob Lai. He is an alumni of this university. He graduated a long time ago, 50 years ago, 1962. Graduated from this university, civil engineering. And he got his PhD degree from Northwestern University. And after that, he went to SUNY Buffalo in New York State as a professor, from assistant professor, associate professor, and professor. And then he went to University of Wisconsin, Milwaukee, as a professor. So then he went to Johns Hopkins University, and he worked in TRW, and also in Taiwan, National Applied Research Lab, as a chairman of board, and then Dalton University, a chair professor. Okay, concerning this course, yeah, how many of you have already registered or taken this course? One? Only one? Okay. Yeah, maybe some other people, if some other students, if you are interested to take this course, then you should go to a university internet to register this course. So for this course, we are going to have every Wednesday, 3:30 to 100 minutes. So if you don't have a break, 10 minutes break, so we are going to have the course, have a class from 3:30 to 5:10 every Wednesday. And classroom over here, and every student should sign in and sign out. So when you come to this this classroom, sign your name, and other class, sign your name again. And we have one TA, Mr. D, Mr. D, yeah, say that, yeah. He will be the TA for this course. So please hang in your report, a short report or final report to him. His phone number, email. His office is on cell phone or this building. Any question? Concerning?
Do we need an app
code
to add?
What?
Do we need an
app code
to add?
No, you don't need. Later on, you can go to. Wait a second. Yeah, tomorrow, you can go to the website called Course Selection System. Course Selection System to add this course. You don't need a slip. Green card slip or any my signature or something like that. So by tomorrow, for tomorrow, you can go to the Course Selection System to add this course. And the final day to end this course September 24th. So you have 2 weeks. To end this course. Any other question? Yeah, please ask. If you have any question. Okay. So this course, any student. Taiwan study program. Any Taiwan study program student? No? Okay. This course is one of the core course for Taiwan study program. Taiwan 研究学程in Chinese. To study some very different topic of concerning Taiwan. And we also offer this course for international student or like you, foreign student or exchange student. So we are going to use English for this course. Oh, I'm not a native American. So, I spent about 6 years in United States. The most popular language in the world is still English. So. I suppose you know how to speak and write by English. Okay, so in this course, we are going to introduce many new technology achievement in Taiwan during the past 20-30 years. Anybody know what's the key or main technology or industry in Taiwan? Yep.
Semiconductor.
Yep, that's one of the key industry of Taiwan. Any others?
Information technology.
Like what? Yeah, computer, or wireless, internet, or smartphone. Do you know one company for mobile phone called HTC? Yeah, it's a Taiwanese company made a smartphone. Yeah. So anybody has a HTC's mobile phone? You, one, two? Okay. I had more than five. I used to buy HTC mobile phone once a year. Recently I switched to Apple. So which company made Apple? Apple mobile phone? Honghai. Honghai in English, Foxconn. Yeah, do you know Foxconn? Foxconn. Foxconn. That's almost the biggest manufacturer company in Taiwan. It's a OEM. They made Foxconn made a lot of different kind mobile phone for many company. Foxconn made mobile phone for Apple, for Nokia, for Motorola. Many name brand and various kinds of mobile phone. Okay, so we are going to talk about this. This is some technology. Maybe in this semester. So, how we teach for this course or every class? Yeah, maybe I will have some presentation, 20-30 minutes. Then we are going to watch a video. Later on, we are going to see one video. Talk about Hsinchu Science Park. So for each class, yeah, we are going to talk about one or two technological topic. And we are going to watch one video. Yeah, maybe 25 or 30 minutes, between 25 to 30 minutes. And we are going to have one or two site visit. I have in mind, one is we are going to take a bus to Hsinchu Science Park. Anybody have been to Hsinchu Science Park? No, that's good. We can go later. Yeah. And the next site visit, we are going to another research center for earthquake research. It's around here. It's one of the research center. It's of our National Applied Research Lab. So we are going to have two site visit. Okay. And for each class, the PowerPoint file, and we can you can see go to a Seba of this university. Seba.ntu.edu.tw 1001 Scientific Taiwan. Yeah, it's a capital S and the capital P. So you can please write on this website. Visit this website. You can have a PowerPoint file and the course online. Let's go to a website. Yeah, over here. Yeah, here is a website of this course. Yeah, you can see some the course name and the course number, course number title of this course, and some description for this course and objectives and the grading policy or evaluation policy for this course. And the PS name, Mr. Lee, of this, and his email and the phone number. Okay, this. Instructor, me, and announcement. Yeah, please check this website. Maybe we have some course. Yeah, so I put the course introduction the file, one PDF file over here. You can download. You can download from this website. And also the course calendar. And the content. The schedule for this course. Yeah, today will be, we are going to have maybe 1 hour the class. Yeah, some briefing of this course. And you can download the file over here. And next week, September 21st, we are going to talk about wireless technology in Taiwan. And one week later, we are going to talk about aerospace technology and defense technology. And October 5th, we don't have a classroom lecture. We want you to go to a World Trade Center to see Taiwan nano exhibition. October 5th. I said for October 5th, and I think 3 days nano exhibition. You can go to World Trade Center exhibition hall to see maybe some new product concerning nanotech. So some new product and some company and some poster or some new machine. So you can see, so you can check the course. Okay. So we have a video for each class. And I will invite one or two professors to come here, to be here to have some special lecture for this course. As I mentioned earlier, we are going to have one or two side visits to earthquake, research center and the Xinru Science Park. Okay, for the grading policy, as I mentioned earlier, you should sign in and sign out for each class. You count 20%, 20% of your grade. And 10% for class interaction. That means you ask a question or answer the question. Starting for next week, not today. So if you ask one or answer one question, the first time you get 3 points. Second time you get 5 points. The next one, then the third time will be 6. Fourth time maybe 7 points, maximum of 10 points. Third part, you are going to hang in 6 shorty posts. So each shorty post will be 5 points for final total grade. And no more than 2 pages, one page or 2 pages. No more than 2 pages, okay? My handwriting and English. English handwriting, no more than 2 pages. So use an A4 paper. Hang in 3 short reports before a midterm test. And another 3 before a final test. And one term report. Term report means choose one specific topic, and like you want to talk about something more detailed about semiconductor technology, or you can do some comparison between your country and Taiwan. Should be more than 5 pages. Hang this term report by end of this semester. And we are going to have 2 midterm tests. One midterm and one final exam. Maybe each exam, maybe about 30 minutes or 40 minutes between. We are going to ask you some question. So it will be 30% of this of your final grade. And also, you can choose one topic to have one presentation. So you can come here to present, maybe 10 minutes. You can choose one topic and give a 10 minutes presentation. And you can form a group, like maybe this up to 3 students. So like if you want to have a presentation by your own, one person. You work with another one, 2% or at the most, let's say, people. Oh. Okay, any question concerning this evaluation or rating policy? Any question?
The short reports, whether they're supposed to be written down.
I cannot hear very clearly.
After the short reports, we're not supposed to write them down.
Oh, what are you are going to talk about? Okay. Let me see. Okay, let's go to the topic. Okay, let's go to the class schedule. Okay, suppose next week we are going to explain something about why this technology. Then you can write one page or two page concerning this specific topic. Okay, so choose maybe okay, over here is November or nice. We don't have class because it's a midterm test week, so we don't have class. So before November 9th, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, classes. So you can choose any three topic from these seven topics. But you must write down something. October 19th, we are going to visit Science Park. It's only a schedule, tentative schedule, temporary schedule. We might change because we are going to have some reservation. We are going to have some tour guide in Science Park. We should make a reservation. Maybe if they are available October 19th, then we go October 19th. If they are not available, if the tour guide is not available on October 19th, maybe we go earlier or later. So maybe everybody should write one or two page short report concerning Science Park. And the other two from different topics. And you can also write something if you visit nano exhibition. You can explain what you see, what are new products, what some nanotech new research, or what a new company you see in the World Trade Center. Okay, any question?
Would you give back the reports before the class or after?
Yeah, after the class. Okay. Yeah, hang in to give your report to TA. Yeah, maybe after the class,
So are the short reports more like reflections on what we learned, or the short parts, are they more like reflections about what we learned?
Yeah, write down something that you know from this class, from this topic, from this video or my lecture,
Is it double space or single space?
Handwriting, one or two pages. you can use a double space. Yeah, maybe TA will do some correction for you. Add something. Add some new marks for you.
Will the trip be the whole day?
Yeah, the trip. Okay, suppose we go to Hsinchu Science Park. Maybe we leave around 12:30 or 1 o'clock and come back because it takes 1 hour. From Taipei to Hsinchu, 1 hour. Maybe we stay there, stay in Hsinchu Science Park, maybe 2 hours. Then come back, we need another 1 hour. So it takes 5-6 hours total. So suppose we leave this university at 1 o'clock. Maybe we come back, maybe 6 or 7 o'clock before dinner time. But another site visit, yeah, National Center for Earth Research on Earthquake Engineering is around here. So, yeah, you all you go directly to the research center. We mean over there. It take 90 minutes or 100 minutes to have the tour. So yeah, so only, yeah, only this site visit, it take a half a day. Yeah. Yeah, because many students have a different course, maybe in the Wednesday morning. Yeah. So I don't want to spend too much time. But if you have a class, maybe earlier this afternoon, like from 1:30 to 3:30, I can give you some letter to say you can have this letter to your class teacher to say we are going to have a site visit to Hsinchu only once. Yeah, it's kind of verification for if you are absent earlier Wednesday afternoon course. Any other question? So please go to this website. You can get some announcement, or you can have a new PowerPoint file or some information from this website. Okay. Now think about the presentation later. Not now. Maybe after another 1 month, you have to have choose one topic. Such as you can choose one topic. Suppose you come from Germany, you can compare what's the technology difference between Germany and Taiwan. As I know, Germany is very good. On renewable technology, renewable energy, right? I think in Germany, you have renewable energy, maybe 20-30%. But Taiwan, renewable energy only, maybe a very small amount only. So you can do some comparison, or you can have some suggestion, what Taiwan should do. For this renewable energy. Actually, last year, one good student from Germany, he explained the energy policy and energy energy resource from in Germany, how many percent of from water, how many percent of energy from gas, or how many percent of energy from oil. And how many percent of the energy from renewable resource. So you can do some research for that. Okay, so course website, there's one website. We had a few years ago, National Applied Research Lab, they made a series of TV video. So you can go to this website to see to watch the video. It's in Mandarin or in Chinese. And then later on, I add some English subtitle. We are going to see one video. But if you want to learn Chinese, you can go to this website. They made 26 different videos. Yeah. Okay, any question concerning this course? Yeah.
I have a class right after this one. So mm-hmm. It's at 5:30. Mm-hmm. So, while we go to the field trip to the science part, do you think maybe you can write a note so that I can tell them kind of make their waiver?
Yeah, as I said earlier, if you have a different courses, earlier this afternoon or later this afternoon, like 5:30 to 6:30, yeah, I can give you later. You can give to a professor. You are not absent with no reason. You have a very proper reason. Any other question? Yeah, concerning the grading policy. Any other question for this? So if you come to the class every time, you get a 20 point. If you ask like five questions or answer five questions, you get another 10 points. So you have 30 points. And then 25 if you hang in every show report. I think the grading is not a problem for you. Okay.
Talking about the final exams, maybe based on the presentations, there is no book we have to buy.
I cannot hear very clear. Can you speak louder? Yeah.
Do we have to buy a book or not?
Yeah, you don't need to buy a book. All the references you can get from a website.
Oh.
Yeah. There's no, the only references is some video, 26 video from this website. And actually, nowadays, you can get a lot of information from Google or Wikipedia. Like you want to know how many mobile phone Apple has sold this year. You just go to a website, right? Yeah, how many computer ASUS sold in last year, not this year, because it's not over yet. But in 2010, yeah, how many personal computer Hewlett Packard sold? And it's very easy. You can get a lot of information through the website. So there's no book or no. This notebook, but please read my PowerPoint file. For each class, I'll put the PowerPoint file on the website. In the website. Any other question?
Yeah. What are the exams based on? Like, is the exams questions going to be about what we learned in class from videos and lectures?
Yeah, I think all the questions I'm going to ask during for the midterm and the final exam, you can get all the information from the video and my PowerPoint file. Yeah, don't worry. So I try to come every week and review my PowerPoint file before the class, before the test. Yeah. This course is something like a general course, a general education course. Yeah, so we don't want to talk too much detail about the technology. Yeah. We are not going to talk about how we made a semiconductor, how we made a mobile phone, but we want to know, have some general introduction to some technology, how Taiwan build up the semiconductor industry, or some nanobio technology. And actually, many technology you can learn from Taiwan. Of course, maybe in your own country, like in the United States, in Germany, in Canada, you have your own major industry also. But I believe later, after you graduate, you are going to do some business, you can get a job related to a high tech industry. Why? Because you can get a very high pay from this company, this high tech company. Okay, if you don't have any question, let's watch one video. So you know what we are going to see in this semester. Okay, let's have a first video.
2018年12月15日，新竹工业科学园区正式揭幕。这里原本是一片茶园，当初计划新建科学园区，没人看好这样的规划。只是任谁也料想不到，原本属于丘陵地的茶园，在20多年之后，竟然摇身变成了全球的科技重镇。
这个地方早期好像大部分是茶园啊，那后是种一些甘蔗，然后还有茶园这些哦，所以当初开始像孙运贤、李国鼎他们来看这块地，开始准备在盖的时候，事实上很多人并不看好，觉得说这块地怎么能够弄成什么一个重要的一个工业基地哈？连电、台积电这样一建起来以后，事实上让整个台湾的这种经济做了一个很大的转变，而且也没想到这个科技的产值啊会变得这么大。
当初的远见造就了今天的成就。新竹科学园区到底对全球科技产业有多重要？1999年921竹科停工一天，造成美国股市动荡，就是最好的证明。
在921地震为例来讲的话啊，那台湾只要稍微一停了以后，那很多美国的公司就非常的紧张，所以也造成一个美国那个股市，造成有一两天这种股市大跌。事实上，它只要停工一天，对整个科学园区大概就造成差不多20亿的这种产值的这种损失啊。科学园区这个地方真的是影响非常大，不是只有对台湾的这个产业经济的影响，事实上也对整个国际上面也非常的那个影响。
工研院在民国76年技术移转，因而成立专业晶圆代工的台积电，正式奠定了台湾成为晶圆制造大国的地位。这片12寸晶圆上头的线宽是头发的千分之一，切割下来的每一小片 IC 关系着所有电子产品的功能以及优劣。而目前台湾的晶圆代工超过全球70%的比重，龙头宝座不言可喻。台积电首创全球专业晶圆代工的模式之后，带动了集体电路产业上中下游以及周边晶圆工业的蓬勃发展，包括 IC 设计、电脑资讯以及光电产业等等。群聚效果是科学园区最大的特色，也是成功的重要关键。
群聚效应是很明显的。那我也是，刚来台湾的时候，我是觉得说，很特别一点，就是说这边的厂商其实那个都会那个帮助彼此。那例如晶圆厂来说，偶尔你会缺个零件、缺个料，那油厂的话，他会帮助你。可是，在国外，那个机会是绝对不可能的。
这不是演唱会，而是科技公司年终尾牙的排场。
一个奖10万啊！一个奖10万。
1945国内抗日，黄思豪，不是黄思豪。
园区造就产业蓬勃发展，而产业则是造就更多的科技新贵。
我们的这个线宽是由小到大，那在很小的时候的确它是很快的。
在竹科上班的人数总计超过10万人，平均每个人的生产力高达新台币958万。竹科生产的桌上型电脑、笔记型电脑以及周边相关产品，像是扫描器、光碟机、终端机、网路卡等等，已经成为全世界最大的供应基地。另外，光电产业是继资讯产业以及半导体产业之后另一个闪闪发光的明星产业。TFT LCD 是从民国87年开始投资，而全球市占率从民国88年的2%升到89年的18%。91年，全球市占率更窜升到36%。光速的成长速度，让台湾成为全球第二大的 LCD 生产供应大国。380多家厂商在632公顷的土地上共同创造奇迹。竹科的营业额从一开始的170亿新台币一路攀升到1兆859亿。
像今年来讲的话，整个新竹科学园区的这种整个产值会超过1兆。那假如说以今年整个台湾所有的工业产值差不多11兆来讲，它就占了差不多1/10。啊，所以你想想看，这个几百公顷的地方，它竟然占了台湾差不多1/10的这个产值。
外墙内涵，100%碳纤维面板。
新竹科学园区创造的不只是经济奇迹，还有高达23项世界第一的产品。首屈一指的当然是晶圆代工，另外 DRAM、IC 封装、大尺寸 TFT LCD、笔记型电脑、LCD 监视器、DVD 光碟片、主机板、以太网路卡、类比数据机，都是世界顶尖。至于排名世界第二的，像是 IC 设计、晶片组、数位相机，也都具有重量级地位。
国外的公司的人来，他们每次来都是觉得哦，很了不起，就是 amazing， 都是用这种话了。就是说，哎，你们可以那个在这么小的地，可以说哎制造这种经济奇迹。
台湾觉得号称说亚洲的四小龙，啊，台湾这么小的一个地方，事实上台湾的这种经济在国际上算是一个经济强国。事实上，最主要就是跟这个产业的这种成功有关系啊。所以现在很多国外的人士他要来台湾参观的话，都把科学园区当成一个最主要的一个参观的一个据点。
竹科的历史几乎就是台湾高科技产业的发展史，25年的竹科发展经验，成功的塑造了台湾今天高科技产业的风貌。在这里，我们目睹了奇迹，也看到了骄傲。科学园区成功地将台湾推向科技大国的行列，而下一步就是要复制竹科经验。民国86年成立南部科学园区，92年成立台中科学园区，台湾西部高科技走廊俨然成型。西部科技走廊必须找寻各自的核心科技，竹科是以半导体以及资讯产业为重心，中部科学园区则是以纳米为基础，南部定位在光电产业，形成北 IC 中纳米南光电的科技优势。奇美第7.5代厂的厂房正在日夜赶工，它的钢筋用量是台北101大楼的2倍之多。1998年才转型的奇美电子， 以黑马之姿投入电脑、电视以及面板的市场。他的成功让南部科学园区的光电产业如虎添翼。
奇美电子从民国87年开始，就在南科开始设厂。那到目前为止，我们已经5座厂开始量产。那奇美电子是在南科是持续的发展，那也希望跟南科一起共创美好的未来。
为了形成光电产业聚落，台南县政府甚至和民间企业合力在南科旁边推动液晶电视专区，也就是俗称的树谷专区。所有液晶电视的上中下游产业统统聚集到这来。
树谷园区就是专门做 TFT LCD 的电视。那这个它的好处是什么呢？它的好处是，它把这个 TFT LCD TV 的这个后段全部在这边生产，因为后段的这个部分组装啊，或者是一些包装啊、物流啦、啊，有一些产业是不适合进入科学园区的。它不适合进入科学园区，如果它的位置又在很远的话，其实园区里面的厂商的成本还是会增加。现在把它抠起来一样，在旁边哈、哦。整个这个聚落变成说区内区外合作起来，这个聚落是完成的，从头到尾一起做下去。现在这个产业是不只是说我们在国内说最完整，甚至跟世界比赛哦，韩国都在学我们现在的这个做法。
磁吸效应是科学园区成功的利器。
旗舰厂商呢，它会带动，它需要有周边产业的这个资源。光电产业跟 IC 产业不一样的地方是，光电产业越做越大。光电的东西是越做越大，越做越大的状况之下呢，就是变成说它的物流运送这个都很困难，就会有比较大的风险。好，那它就更需要把它的聚落产业聚落集合在一起，这样呢风险也小，然后成本也低，然后效率也好。
除了吸引光电产业之外，开发其他核心价值也同样重要。这里是电信技术中心。是正在测试电视受到电波干扰的情形。为了让光电产业更加健全，电信技术中心率先进驻南科，希望带动南科成为通讯重镇。电信中心是台湾第一家数位电视接收机检验的实验室，换言之，未来液晶电信业者只要在国内一次验证，就可以全球通关。
我们在技术中心里面有设那个广电检测实验室，所以将来那个一些电视产业哈，液晶产业方面的就可以在那边能够就地在地化来提供检测服务。我们现在还有一个目标，就是希望来争取申请加入一个国际的一个组织 CCRA 的组织。如果我们拿到这个加入这个组织的话，将来我们认可的自然产品呢，就不必再到输入国做检测，比如国内一次验证，全球通关。
不同于南科全力发展光电以及通讯产业，身为精密机械大本营的台中，自然锁定以精密工业为中科的核心科技。
中部地区的话，是我们所有台湾里面精密机械业70%都集中在台中，所以我们在推动开发中部科学园区的时候，我们首先考量的是引进光电的大厂。我们全世界里面12寸的晶圆厂最密集的地方就在台湾，而台湾将来就在我们中科。我们算一算他们的投资计划里面，我们有14座的12寸晶圆厂将来会在我们这边来成型。
由于友达光电的国际旗舰大厂进驻，迅速带动中下游厂商跟进，以至于中科土地供不应求。现在除了台中园区，又继续向外围扩建，包括后里园区以及虎尾园区。其中云林的虎尾园区连接中科以及南科，具备地理优势。
那我们在第一期开发的时候，我们从筹措计划开始核准到我们厂商建厂，第一期的开发是花了10个月又5天的时间。那第三期的这个开发，后里的开发， 我们花了九个月零四天的时间，所以这个行政的效率来讲，是我们中科成功的一个最主要的因素。
无论中科、竹科还是南科，产业界的产值快速攀升，其中政府提供的环境优势是重要因素。以高雄园区为例，厂房的土地租金1000坪，一个月只要36万左右的租金。
我们知道光电产业里面的竞争的一个优势，必须是设备的成本要降低。那我们跟韩国来比的时候，那我们的这些的光电大厂最主要就是成本没办法降下来的原因，就是自制力没办法提高。韩国的整个的设备的自制力是达到60%几，台湾只有10%几，所以我们这边要借助我们整个中台湾的一个优势，也就是精密机械业跟它结合起来。那现在我们在这样的一个效应已经可以充分的展现出来了。
园区还很重要的，它供应很稳定的水电这种资源。除了这个之外呢，我们整个把单一窗口，就是你在地方必须要到各个处室啊、局务去做的这个业务呢，在园区里面，你只要找到一个窗口，所有事情都会，我们内部就会帮你解决。
拥有优势环境，自然能够创造更高的产值。预估竹科95年的营业额可以达到1兆2000亿，南科以5000亿的黑马姿态紧追在后，中科有1200亿的规模，两兆双星也难成行。台湾西部高科技走廊是政府和民间产业结合的最佳典范，因为唯有深耕台湾，才能进军世界。
Video. This video talk about Hsinchu Science Park. Any question? Consider this video. No? If you don't have question, let me ask you some question. Okay. Where in Taiwan? Where is the first science park in Taiwan? Which city?Yep, Hsinchu. Yeah, very, very right. Yeah, Hsinchu. In Taiwan. In Taiwan, we have a first science park. In Hsinchu. Which year? When we built this Hsinchu science park? When we start to build this Hsinchu science park?
Years.
This girl.
No.
I
was here.
Taiwanese year, okay. You know Taiwanese year. It's our year, not Taiwanese year. 1976. So about thirty years ago. How many company in this Hsinchu Science Park? How many companies? 5 years ago.This video was taken 5 years ago. 5 years ago, how many companies in Hsinchu Science Park?
300 and 400.
So again?
Between 300 and 400.
Yeah, in the video, it says 380 companies. But right now, they have already, I think the Hsinchu Science Park has more than 400 companies.So, and the number of the company is changing every year. So I don't know how many companies right now. It fluctuates. Every year the number is increasing. And right now they have more than 420. Actually, you can go to website, Google or some other, or Hsinchu Science Park website.You can check how many company are in Hsinchu Science Park. I believe more than 420 right now. Can you name three company in this Hsinchu Science Park, first Science Park? Any three companies? Anybody know? In the film, it says many companies. any two company? Yep.
Qimei.
Qimei not in Hsinchu Science Park. Not Qimei. Qimei is in southern Taiwan. Yeah, it's another company. Also made a LCD display. Another big company. Another big company made LCD monitor, TV. Not Asus is a company for computer and a notebook. Yeah, Asus. Asus has many buildings in Hsinchu Science Park. And another one? Anyone? One more? Acer, right? Do you know the name of the company name Acer? Yeah, Acer. Acer was second biggest company in the world. Acer. Asus, maybe top five. Yeah. Second biggest company for notebook and PC. Any big company you know? TSMC, you know TSMC? Anybody know TSMC? It's the biggest company for semiconductor fabrication company. Taijidian in Chinese. It's like the CPU or NVIDIA display chip. It's the biggest company in the world for OEM. They don't have a membrane. They made IC chip for some other companies, like for Apple. Apple CPU, right now they use A5. And they are going to make A6. And they made a lot of chip, IC chip, for many other companies. Yeah, we are going to see many buildings, TSMC, more than 10 huge buildings, more than 10. And also a very huge building. I mentioned earlier, Qimei, instead of Qimei, Qimei is the main factory is in southern Taiwan. In Hsinchu Science Park, another world company, Youda, in Chinese. I think it's second or third biggest company making LCD or TV. And what else? Optical disc, CD, DVD, CD. Many company make DVD, CD. Make a Logitech, make a mouse or keyboard, Logitech. You can see Logitech in Hsinchu Science Park. Asus and Acer and AUO, TSMC, UMC, another company, second biggest company, UMC, for semiconductor fabrication. Okay. Yep.
Do any of these companies receive tax breaks for locating in science parks?
Yeah. If you, suppose you want to have a factory or company inside Hsinchu Science Park, you should file application. And you should be like a high-tech company. And should have some minimal amount of revenue. It cannot be too small. Okay, you want to have you have very high tech, but your company is only 5 people. You cannot be allowed to have a company inside Science Park. So you should file an application. So such as your company has some very unique high tech. What's the employee of your company? Maybe I don't know what's the minimum number. Minimal revenue of your company. So you can have allowed to have a company inside science park. And then you can get some benefit, like a tax deduction. Yeah, maybe outside Hsinchu Science Park, outside Science Park, maybe you should pay like a 20% tax. Inside, maybe you just pay, I don't know, maybe 10%. You have some tax advantage. Yeah, so actually many company want to have set up a factory or company inside Science Park. Yeah, one last question. How many science park in Taiwan right now? Hsinchu Science Park is the first one. And then after that, inside the video, we have the Southern Taiwan, right? Southern Taiwan Science Park. And in Taichung, we have the Central Taiwan Science Park. How many else? Four? Any other, anybody has a different number?
Five.
Any different numbers? Actually, the number is increasing every year. Yeah, you know, Hsinchu Science Park. Hsinchu Science Park is the first one and very successful. Then, the space is very limited. So they try to expand Science Park. So they have in Zhunan, in a bit south of Hsinchu Science Park, and Zhunan and some other place. So actually there are two or three more around Hsinchu Science Park. And also, Central Taiwan also. Yeah, there are many small science park around Central Science Park. And also in Tainan, Kaohsiung Science Park, and also Taipei, you know, Neihu Science Park, and Langgang Science Park, for software and biotech. Yeah, maybe later you can get a job around here, Neihu or Langgang. So I don't know what's the exact number for the science park. I believe more than 10. So if it later, maybe later means maybe 10 years later or 20 years later, you get a job or you want to set up a company, try to build up a company inside a science park. Okay, so any other question you want to ask? For next week, I'm going to ask TA, Mr. Li, to ask, we are going to have maybe 10 minutes TA's time. He's going to ask you some question. So try to pay attention when I teach in the class or when you watch the video. He's going to ask you some question. So any question concerning this course or this class? No?